When most people think about Bavarian beer, first things that come to mind are Munich, Lederhosen, and of course, the Oktoberfest. But now, get ready to get your core beliefs shaken. While it is true that most German breweries are located in Bavaria, Munich is actually not the heart of Bavarian beer culture. Instead, it is way up north in the region of Upper Franconia where you will find an agglomeration of breweries that is unique in the world. Approximately every third Bavarian brewery can be found here. And this gets even more distinct when you take into account the number of inhabitants. The locals call it Brauereidichte, which means brewery density, an index that is measured by inhabitants per brewery. The fewer inhabitants, the higher the Brauereidichte, which can be quite confusing at first. So always keep in mind to look for the smallest value. Upper Franconia is not only the highest Brauereidichte of all the regions in Bavaria, but also on the entire planet. But this impressive number is even dwarfed when you regard the municipality of Aufsitz alone. Here only 1,266 inhabitants share a total of 4 breweries among themselves. For comparison, if Munich with its population had such a Brauereidichte as Aufsitz, instead of just 6 breweries, there would be 4,600. If you enlarge the Oktoberfest by this ratio, you would need a Theresian Wiese that is larger than 3.5 times the size of Manhattan. Upper Franconia has not only a superior Brauereidichte, but it is also well known for its immense diversity of beers. Beyond the usual German variety of Pils, Weizen and Lager, Upper Franconia has to offer dark, light, Keller, Märzen, Bock and, of course, the famous smoke beers. In total, there are about 1,000 different beers. So, how did it all come about? To find the answer, we have to look into the history of the region. For centuries, Bamberg and the surrounding area was ruled by the archbishops. These bishops had a quite open-handed policy of conferring brewing rights. More breweries, more taxes. So they supported new foundations, even in the smallest villages. Another reason is the fragmented political situation. Small barons, counts, free knights and towns had the privilege to confer brewing rights on their own. Furthermore, several important trade routes crossed in today's Upper Franconia, so it was lucrative to found inns and taverns alongside the roads. Many of those small inns brew beer on their own because it was not easy to transport and not very durable. After Upper Franconia became a part of Bavaria in the early 1800s, the liberalization of the economy led to a founding boom and even more breweries. In 1840, during the highest point, there were even 1,100. But of course, as everywhere else since the beginning of the industrialization, most of those closed down in favor of bigger, highly industrialized brewing companies. Yet, this process went much slower than everywhere else. So even today, most of the breweries in the region are still tiny, family-owned craft businesses who somehow survived in a highly competitive and globalized market. A fact that cannot be fully explained rationally. Maybe it has something to do with the stubbornness of the Upper Franconians and their love for their local beer. Cheers!